You can use ChatGPT to write SEO-rich blog articles for your website. And in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to do that. Let me share my screen with you here. All right, so this is the end result. It took me about 20 minutes to write up this blog article. I'm going to show you exactly how to do the same for you. A couple things you're going to notate here. An SEO-rich headline here for your title for your article. Tons of SEO-rich notes here. One of the coolest things with this program is it's actually going to do the research for you. It's going to give you citations for all the data points. Incredibly, incredibly powerful. I can tell you that this is a great way to drive hits to your website. You can empower your team to do this for you. It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. So let me show you exactly how I was able to create this blog article. So I'm here in ChatGPT. I'm using Model 4 here. This is the newest version of ChatGPT. And you're going to start this out by saying, hey, ChatGPT, let's do this step by step. Now, this is important because one of the limitations to this program is it gets tired, it gets bored, and about halfway through your 1,500-word blog article, it's going to stop. So I'm going to show you exactly why this is important. So say, hey, let's do this step by step. Write me a 1,500-word blog on why businesses should advertise on podcasts. Now, whatever is relevant to your business, this could be why you should shop at my store, why you should eat more celery in your diet. I don't care. Whatever your business is, plug that in. 1,500-word blog on why it should do it. In fact, you can actually use ChatGPT to give you ideas on what people are going to be looking for and reading. Regardless, I run a podcast production agency. I'm using tons of AI, and this is what I wanted to do. I'm trying to find advertisers for some of my shows. So first off, you can see it's giving me the title. It's giving me an introduction, and then it started going through here and give me all the different reasons why people should advertise. And I noticed here that it's saying stuff like, according to Edison Research, the number of monthly podcast listeners in the United States has grown from 32 million in 2013 to over 116 million in 2021. So throughout the course of this article, it's going to give a bunch of citations, all right? So by the way, we use this term, let's do a step-by-step at the beginning. Now we're going to ask it to continue because you can see that it just stopped typing. All of a sudden, just stopped typing halfway through the article. We don't want that. We want it to continue. Very simple prompt, okay? And then you can see it's going to go ahead and conclude the post. Now, mind you, you might decide you don't want a 1,500-word article. You want a 3,000-word article. It doesn't really matter. Using this, let's do this step by step, and then asking it to continue will give you the prompt that you want. Now, one of the things that I noted here was the writing was a little bit boring, so I said, hey, please write it again to be more compelling and with more references, right? Pretty solid. So it goes through here and you can read the examples here. Harness the untapped potential, why podcast advertising is a game changer for businesses. Way more compelling than the power of podcast advertising, why businesses should invest in this growing medium. It's just more compelling. I don't know what to tell you. Ask ChatGPT to be more compelling and it will be. So it goes through here. It gives me all this text. And then I noted here that, hey, you're referencing all these studies, but I need the website links for these referenced studies. And boom, it gave me five references, these studies reports. I got to tell you, this type of research just a few years ago would have taken hours for you to do. Now you can do it in less than 20 minutes. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable. Then I said, hey, can you give me more reasons to advertise on podcasts? Like, yeah, you gave me, a handful, but I want more. I want more. So it gave me another, three or four different reasons. Also, it gave me references to the studies that had been completed. Again, I asked, give me more reasons to advertise on podcasts with links. It keeps going and going. And I noted that I wasn't really happy with the conclusion. I said, please write me a conclusion. Boom, did it. And I said, you know what? I'm running a freaking business here. I want to drive leads to my business. I want people to buy. And, if you don't ask, you don't get. So I said, hey, rewrite this conclusion, but I want a call to action for businesses that are interested in podcast advertising to reach out to Mark Savant Media. That's the name of my podcast agency where we merge podcasting, AI, and human power all together to give you the best podcast possible. Anyway, so it did that, gave it to me. And I said, okay, cool. Well, now I need titles. So I said, give me 10 different titles, 10 new titles with a positive sentiment, power word, and a number. The reason I said that is because power words are important for SEO and numbers are important for compelling readers to continue to read. Then I said, hey, you know, there's some interesting stuff out there about the buying power of podcast listeners. This is probably not hyper relevant to you and your business, but again, you can start to see how you're forming this blog article, right? Again, give me more links, more references to the power of podcasts. This type of research, again, I can't emphasize this enough. This type of stuff could take you hours to do, and it just does it within seconds. It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. Give me blog headers for each of the points listed above. Now, blog headers are important because that's going to help Google understand where you rank, and it's going to show your post to more people. So again, give me blog headers, be SEO cognizant. These are the types of things you want to be asking ChatGPT to do. And then lastly, I said, hey, let's rewrite this title, podcast advertising in the beginning, just because I was trying to find that optimal title. And that's it, my friends. You've just written a giant, highly SEO-rich blog article for your website. You're going to go ahead and copy and paste this into WordPress. Make sure that you set up your H1 headers and your H2 headers. Your whatever site you're using will explain that. I'll be going into more detail on this in future episodes. But I wanted to get your beak wet. I wanted to give you a taste of what it's like and how powerful this new technology is for your business, your competition. They're not doing this yet. They don't know. They do not know what's happened. If you adopt this now, you're going to be at a massive advantage. They're not going to be able to keep up. They're just not going to be able to keep up. So go ahead and apply this in your business today. Make sure if you want more of this stuff, hit subscribe now. Hit the subscribe button and I will catch you in the next video. Oh yeah. And guess what? By the way, if you're looking at learning in real time, asking real time questions, I'm going to put a link below to my mastermind community. Join the mastermind today. We're going to be talking about what's working over the next 10 years, not what's worked over the past 10 years. We're going to grow your damn business. Click subscribe, join the community, and I'll catch you next video. Peace.